Welcome to my dear students. We are going to physics second year electric charges and fields class 5. Now we have already discussed the electric field, electric lines of flow, intensity of electric field. The intensity of electric field, then E is equal to F by rho naught. It is the intensity of electric field. The force experienced by unit force to test charge is known as intensity of electric field. And the intensity of electric field due to a point charge, the equation is E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q pi r square. It is intensity of electric field due to a point charge. Okay. Now discussing about electric flux. What is the electric flux? What is the electric flux? It is denoted by current. The number of electric lines of force or passing through from unit area is called electric flux. Actually, it is the unit area. The number of electric lines of force or passing through from unit area, it is known as electric flux. The units of electric flux is Weber. Next, intensity of electric field due to electric flux. The number of the electric flux is passing through from unit area. Passing through from unit area is known as intensity of electric field. Then E is equal to pi E by E. It is the equation of intensity of electric field. Now we will cross multiplication. Then pi E is equal to E dot A. It is the scalar part. Then pi E is equal to E A cos theta. But the theta means the angle between electric field and area. Then theta is equal to 0. Okay, friend. Then cos 0 is equal to 1. Then pi E is equal to E A. It is maximum. Then theta is equal to 90. What mean? The area of direction and electric field as means are perpendicular to each other. Then cos 90 value 0, then pi E equal to 0, it is minimum. Then theta is equal to 180 degrees. What happened when the theta is equal to the area of direction and electric field direction is the opposite direction. Then theta is equal to 180, cos 180 that is equal to minus 1. Then pi E is equal to minus EA. It is the negative. Okay, and second, what is the electric flux? The number of electric lines of force are passing through from unit area is called electric flux. Units what are Weber. But what is the intensity of electric field? The electric flux is passing through from unit area is called electric field or intensity of electric field. Then E is equal to pi A. Now pi is equal to E dot A. Yeah, dot means scalar. Then remove the scalar product, cos theta. When theta is equal to 0, cos 0 that is equal to 1, then pi is equal to EA, it is the maximum. Then theta is equal to 90, then cos 90 value is equal to 0, then pi is equal to 0, it is the minimum. Then theta is equal to 180, then pi is equal to minus EA, it is the negative, it is the electric plus. You put now the important topic. In electric field charges, it is the Gauss law. Gauss law in electricity is the most important topic. Gauss law in electricity is the important topic. Gauss law in electricity. But what is the Gauss law? Already we are discussing electrics. What is the meaning of the electric plus? The number of electric lines of force are passing through from unit area is known as electric flux. Now, Gauss law in electricity. Now we consider it is the closed surface. The total electric flux passing through from closed surface, it is pi E. Once again, the total electric flux is passing through from closed surface is equal to 1 by epsilon naught terms of net charge of enclosed surface That is called Gauss law in electricity. Once again, the total electric plus is force per enclosed surface is equal to 1 by epsilon naught terms of net charge of enclosed surface is called Gauss law. Now, if you like to write that equation, then pi is equal to enclosed charge that is not q, then q into 1 by epsilon naught. The total electric plus force through enclosed surface is equal to 1 by epsilon naught net charge of enclosed surface is known as Gauss law. Now we can write pi is equal to 1 by epsilon naught into q, then pi is equal to q by epsilon naught. But what about the epsilon naught? Epsilon naught means permittivity of free space. Then pi is equal to q by epsilon naught. Now another equation, then pi is equal to over integral EDS that is equal to q by epsilon naught. It is a dot product. Or then pi is equal to over integral EDS cos theta that is equal to q by epsilon naught. It is the Gauss law in But what is the importance of the Gauss law? It is the importance. What is the importance? Importance. What is the importance of the Gauss law? The Gauss law is useful in calculating simple calculation of electric field any closed surface, the first one. And the second one, it is useful. It does not depend on size and shape of the closed surface. And the third one, it is useful in calculating electric field with the symmetrical distributed charge at any closed surface. And fourth one, it is used for stable charge and rest charge. These are importance of the Gauss law. Once again, what is the first important? That it is useful in simply calculating electric field for any surface. Second one, it does not depend on size and shape of the body or surface. Third one, it is useful to calculate electric field due to symmetrical charges distributed any surfaces. Fifth one, it is used for electrical charges, stable charges, resistive charges. This is the importance of the Gauss law. But now we are discussing small definition for Gauss law. What is the simple definition? The first definition is linear charge density. Linear charge density. Now, what is the linear charge density? Simple definition. The unit length of charge of conductor is known as linear charge density. It is denoted by lambda, then lambda is equal to q by L. Second, the unit length of charge is known as linear charge density. The lambda is equal to q by L. Now, the units of the linear charge density, the lambda is equal to, the charge is equal to the coulombs. Now, we can write the units, coulombs, coulomb. For length units of meter, coulomb per meter. Next, another definition. Surface charge density. What is the meaning of the surface charge density? It is denoted by sigma. It is a unit length of charge of conductor, but the sigma is equal to q by s. What is the definition? Unit surface area of conductor, of charge of conductor, is known as surface charge density. Then sigma is equal to q by s. Now, units of surface charge density, then you can write this. Charge coulomb, but surface area is what? Meter square. The third one is the value charge density. What is the value charge? It is denoted by rho. The rho is equal to, put in the formula, q by v. But here, unit length of charge, that is known as linear charge density. Here unit surface area of charge is known as surface charge density. Similarly, unit volume of charge of a conductor, unit volume of charge of a conductor is known as volume charge density. Now we can write units. What are units? Now charge coulomb, for values meter cube, linear charge density, surface charge density and volume charge density. These are simply definitions that are important for Gauss law.